Woohoo!
Starship has hopped!
We can't believe it!
Yeah! Starship!
It's crazy!
Starship
what's
hopped.
Going on?
I cannot believe my eyes!
Woohoo!
Starship didn't
explode! It has really happened!
150 meter hop!
It has happened! Starship has flown! For the first time in history! Exactly as the Ron Paul memes predicted. Fortunately, we went to the happening bunker before it happened and watched the whole event from there. Joking aside, to celebrate this insane and joyous occasion, we thought, hey, why not do a special episode on the successful 150-meter hop test with SN5? But only with voiceover today, because we looked like shit after staying up all night. So let's right away analyze this wonderful hop test. We basically can say the following. Flawless. Picture perfect.
After the aborted test from earlier in the day, we really saw Starship SN5 taking off. The coolest thing was to see the offset Raptor engine handling the entire weight of the SN5 with no problems. Insane! And the flight was smoother than Starhopper's flight almost exactly 1 year ago. While Starhopper had a few hiccups, for example, an aggressively yellow flame, and a quite rough landing due to Raptor shutting off too early, SN5 didn't experience any hiccup. Just pure perfection. Even the landing legs. Look at this here. It's crazy how perfectly the landing legs even worked. Every single one of them. Now this prompted Elon to tweet some interesting stuff, of course. He said that progress is accelerating. Which we found highly interesting, because this means that the SN5 hop is right on Elon's aggressive time schedule.
Because he famously said that if progress isn't accelerating, then we won't make it to Mars in his lifetime. So that's really good to hear from Elon. Then he said that SpaceX will want to do several short hop tests in order to smooth out the launch process. After that, on to higher altitude with body flaps. Of course, Elon is talking about incrementally higher flight tests, maybe with SN5 or later with SN6. And then the real 20-kilometer hop test with subsequent skydiving maneuver, which we often mentioned, and which Orbital Vetch so perfectly rendered in this cool animation here. This will probably take place with SN8. Which will be completely mounted with wings and flaps and nose cone. Starship SN8 will already use the new steel alloy, which Elon has been talking about all the time. Had SN5 and even SN6 still been built with 301 stainless steel, Starship SN8 will then be the first one to use the new alloy based on 304L, which will have even better toughness at cryogenic temperatures. So the success of Starship SN5's hop we witness now will directly enable the SN8 20-kilometer flight test. So the event now has huge positive consequences for Starship development, and therefore for all our dreams of cities on the moon and on Mars.
But before we get ahead of ourselves, we should note that this hop test was really so important because compared to the Starhopper, it was a true first test of Starship hardware. Starship will be built with the same methods as SN5, even though it will have a differing steel alloy, the rest will be the same. Same tank configuration, same steel size and curvature, same Raptor engine. So this today really marked the beginning of Starship flights, and is thus an absolutely historical day. Historical! And people, let's not forget that SpaceX has now applied for FCC approval for the 20-kilometer hop tests to occur from August 18th this year to the 18th of February next year.
Yes, really. We could see the 20-kilometer Starship hop with skydive maneuver already by year's end, or early next year, or hell, even in 2 months, if Elon kicks into overdrive mode. So yeah, this is why we are so excited. Because this SN5 hop really means that we are on our freaking path to Mars. A Mars cargo launch in 2022 is therefore not so unrealistic anymore. Yuzaku Maezawa's Dear Moon mission in 2023. Not so unrealistic suddenly. Even a crewed moon landing in 2024 with Starship. Not so unrealistic anymore after today. Mars landing with astronauts still in this decade. Not so unrealistic anymore after this wonderful event. So we hope you are as excited as we are. We certainly are. Because this is really one of the most important days for humanity.
On par with the invention of the wheel or fire. Yes, really. Because this day, friends, will be one day in the future on Mars, maybe in Utopia Planitia City, be looked back upon by Mars scholars and Mars historians, and they will say, look, it all started back then. It all started with this metal cylinder flying 150 meters high into the blue Texan sky. And if you're new here and would like to learn more about Elon's future Moon and Mars colonization timeline, you can watch this video here. The JS Disruption Report will release tomorrow because of this special occasion. We wish you a wonderful day on this occasion and see you tomorrow for the JS Disruption Report.